Auckland, New Zealand. I mean, where else do you find a pop group wearing grass skirts? The third leg of the Whitbread Around the World race is about to start, and so is my part in this adventure. This is the leg that will take us from New Zealand across the Southern Ocean to the legendary Cape Horn, and then up the Argentine coast to Punta del Este in Uruguay. Skip Novak, our captain, has insisted that everyone have 2 weeks of real holiday before this leg, which is a pretty good idea when you've sailed over 14,000 miles and been living out of each other's pockets on a boat that's only 77 feet long. Every small boat in Auckland is milling around in the harbour to see all the competitors off. I wave goodbye to my wife and say hello to a routine that won't change for the next 5 weeks. There's no special treatment for me. I'm a crew member and I work alongside the others. But for me, an extraordinary experience is about to begin.
Drum was bought as a shell in January 1985 and launched in June. With only 3 months to the start of the Round the World race, it was important that we do some serious racing to see how the boat performed. Other Maxis that were going to go around the world had been racing for a year or more, exploring the potential of their boats and welding a crew together into a unit. We had a lot of catching up to do. The Seahorse Maxi series was our first chance. The Solent dished up its usual balmy summer sailing weather, but Drum showed her pace, and we won the event. 10 days later, we set out on the Fastnet race.
Quite a heavy wind and quite a big sea, and of all things, the keel sheared off the boat. It took about 20-30 seconds to go actually turtle upside down. There were people trapped inside the hull, and people were in the water. And I think due to the teamwork, it is only due to the teamwork and professionalism and level-headedness of the crew that we are all 24 of us still alive today.
Luckily, someone on shore had seen Drum capsize, and a helicopter arrived after 40 minutes, bringing a diver who rescued those trapped inside. Drum was abandoned, and she floated for 2 days before she could be towed back to Falmouth.